gift. We thank God for the giver. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the whole church say amen.
Amen.
Listen, I just want to say this morning, I am happy in Jesus.
Amen.
Everybody happy in Jesus?
Come on, this is Easter.
your life. Have you ever thought about what that means, to lean on the everlasting arms? You know, church, the last 3 years have really taught me something. Living in and through a pandemic, we have seen a lot of difficulties. But you know what? The pandemic gave us a chance to sit down for a little bit and look around at the world. And it's kind of scary because you look at your phone, you look on the internet, you look at the TV, you look on social media, and you see all the difficulties in the world. You see the suffering, you see people mourning, you see people in addiction, you see people who are in financial constraints, you see people in all kinds of things that we didn't even think about. You know, there was a time in life when news to me happened between 6 and 7. 6 o'clock, 6:30, 7 o'clock, that was it. But now we're in an ongoing news cycle every day. Tornadoes are coming. Hurricanes are coming. Earthquakes are happening somewhere. The economy is tanking somewhere. Wars, rumors of wars. It seems like we have this unending world of sadness. But I'm reminded of what it says in the book of Job. A man born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. You see, even becoming a Christian does not protect us from trouble. I'm going to say that again. Becoming a Christian does not protect us from trouble. And if you pick up your cross and follow Jesus, you just might walk right into something that you did not expect. After all, we know rain falls on the just and the unjust. And I'm thinking about the words my grandmother would say, the devil is busy. Y'all heard that? The devil is busy. The Bible tells us that the devil is walking back and forth on the crowd, looking for someone to devour. And we know that he works directly and indirectly. The devil was so bold that he even challenged Jesus, tempted him to deviate away from the plans of his father. But Jesus taught us something. What did he teach us? Resist the devil, and what will he do? Flee. But here's the issue for me. And I've said this before, church, you've heard me say this. It's one thing to know the word. It's another thing altogether to live the word. I can sit here all day and say, trust in the Lord with all thy heart, leaning not on your own understanding. And what do I do? First thing in the morning, God, I'm trusting in you today. 95% of the day, I'm leaning on my own understanding. God says, bring your burdens, place them upon me. And I say, Lord, you can have this one and that one, but I'm holding on to these two over here. This one's a little embarrassing, and this one is maybe just a little too hard. Why do we do that? I could walk through the valley of the shadow of death, fear no evil, but I can't make that one phone call I need to make. Why do we do this? Because the devil doesn't just directly come at us. He indirectly comes at us. He goes into our hearts. He knows the desires of our hearts. And he may not touch you directly. He said, you know what, I'm going to touch your children. For many of us, he said, I'm going to touch your wallet. For many of us, I'm going to touch your mind. And what do we do? Our lives become chaotic. We worry, stress, all of those things. But I'm going to tell you, there's some good news. We're going to get into that a little bit. But think about the resurrection.
what does it mean?
Have you ever thought about that? Sometimes you have to get into your own mind and think, what does the resurrection mean? I know he got up, but what do we get out of him getting up? So my brothers and sisters, today, I know our life is hard. But in our story today, we're going to visit a family who's going through what many of us are going through, tough times. It is a family who has experienced death and the loss of children. They are suffering from loneliness. They are experiencing many of the things that we feel on a daily basis. And like many, are drowning in their problems. And sometimes, you know, life gets us down so much that we feel that if God himself has forgotten about us. But I told you, there is good news, because why? We have the victory. This play today, this little skit, is an illustration of the words. And I told you during Black History Month about the importance of music. And I think about one song when I think about this play. Because he lived, I can face tomorrow. So I want you to think about that. How are you going to face tomorrow? Because he lived. So ladies and gentlemen, I won't talk any further. I'm going to present to you our resurrection skit this morning. So give a hand as we get ready to get started, because there's a lesson in this for all of us. Thank you. Amen. Victory is mine. Brother Lynn, whose is it? It's mine.
Good. But I can't wait. trusted. And can be trusted. Don't y'all trust? You don't trust it. They don't have no peace. And absolutely no joy. Because they don't believe that they can. Because all they have to do is walk in his victory every single day of their stupid little life. There I go. But hey, it ain't my fault. It ain't my fault because they don't read that book. You know, that book. Saying, go ahead. Y'all just keep on doing what you're doing. See, I'll just keep running things up in here. Y'all know what I mean. Keep on. Because see, it works out perfectly for me. Oh, y'all were so confused. I am too. Because all you need is an example. And I'm going to give you one. Let's check in on one of my little favorite Christian families.
Talk about know putting you in that new school was a bit of an adjustment, but I just want the best education for you possible.
Wait a minute, Brenda. Are they messing with you up in that school? What's it called?
Bullying.
Yeah, bullying. Greg will come up in here and say, no. I'm just saying, son, don't nobody be messing with Greg's face.
I'm gonna die. I'd rather die than go back to that school.
What?
Dad, please go back to that school. Please, please.